Hey everybody, so today I was kind of cleaning up my filters and I thought maybe I'd do a little bit of a talk about them, kind of what kind of filters I use and why I use them and why I like them so much. And the filters that I kind of prefer to use are the Lee filters, and I've never used any other filters. This is the only filters I've used, and I think they're expensive, but they're really, really worth it. The system that I use is the 100 system. If you are looking to buy it or to invest in it, it comes with the filter holder, and I have the adapter, which is currently on the lens, so I don't choose that. So the adapter, you just screw it on your lens and you just clip, hang this on it. And what's nice about these filters is that when I want to attach the polarizer, it's just kind of, I just kind of screw it on here. The only issue I have with it, it's kind of a very small, you can see, I don't know if you can see that, I'm gonna try to show you. So once I see, it's right there, if you can see that, it's kind of small, so it's hard to get a good grip, but once it's under, it's secure. But sometimes it's hard to get a grip because the part that you actually turn is really, really small compared to the part that you use for a tube polarizer. But it's really nice in case of that it's really small, and it just really doesn't take a lot of room and fits nicely on the front, and it gives you option to put two filters or maybe three or four in front of it, so you can adjust these and add the filter holders as you get. So when you get them, you get not just the two here that you see, you get more. So usually, like if I'm putting filters together, I can just kind of slide them in right here, slide on the other, slide in, let's say, an ND filter right here on top, and right now it fits all three. But I can fit more, I can fit like four on top if you want to get that crazy. Usually I only use three filters at the same time maximum. I don't combine them more because I feel like this can just take you into a whole different scenario. So I do like this system. Now I want to talk a little bit about the filters that I use. I have two soft edge ND filter and two hard edge. And you can see the soft edge and the hard edge. You can see the difference. Both these are three stops and these two are two stops each, so you can kind of see the difference here. Now what I like to use about filters is, like, you can shoot HDR if you want, and this is like you bracket your shots and you get a higher dynamic range, and I like that. I'm not bitching about HDR. I do like that. I've played around a lot with HDR. Right now I don't like it anymore. I kind of fell out of interest with it, and I like the fact using filters because I feel like when you're out taking pictures on landscapes and you're kind of using filters, you can get to see the image, what it looks like, and you can get to see the fruit of your labor, and you can get to see the image come to life as you add the filters and you do different things. So it's more fun and it's more like artistic in my opinion. Now HDR is really, really good technology, and it's kind of crazy how far it's come, and I definitely like the effect of it, but it's an artistic choice, right? You can either choose to take that direction, or you can choose to use a more pure direction where you use filters and stuff. And I really recommend these filters from Lee. Like, I think they're worth investing. You know, you gotta be careful, better than me, because I really, you know, kind of dropped this one and I should be careful because they're expensive, but luckily this one is still usable. So I have, I have two soft edge, two hard edge, both in two stops and three stops. I have one circular polarizer right here, also from Lee. It's a 105, so it's really, really big, and this promises that you pretty much don't get any vignetting when you use it because it's such a big filter. So when you're using a 60mm lens and you're shooting really wide, I've never noticed any vignetting. It works really nicely. And I got a 6 stop and a 10 stop ND filter and a 15 stop. Now the 6 stop and 10 stop, they're perfect for like sunset. If you're shooting at like sunset or sunrise, if you want to do a long exposure, sometimes I go with the 6 stop because a 10 stop might be like a really long time. You might be out there for 4 minutes shooting a picture. That could make for a nice effect, but 6 stop, as long as you get enough time to make a long exposure, you should get nice effects with it, sunrise or sunset. Where the 15 stop or the 10 stop comes in useful, if you want to shoot at a shallower depth of field, like you want to shoot f4, f2.8 in the middle of the day, you put on the 15 stop and it will help you pretty much kind of shoot longer in the day. If you're shooting waterfall and you want just your focus on the waterfall, this will be really helpful for that. So I'll make a video kind of shooting with that one day just to kind of go over it. But this is kind of it for filters that I use. And I put all these filter in these, I put the filter holder in its own pouch that came with it. All these filters, they come with pouches like this for them, but just to make your life a lot easier, I would get this. If you're interested in buying this system and investing, this is kind of what I would buy the kit to start. And I would get this 10, I think there's 10 filters that fit in this. It's also from Lee. It's a nice bag, and you can actually have a little hook to actually hook it up on you onto your tripod. Also, I would not recommend that. If it's windy, it will kind of shake the tripod. So I'd rather keep that not hanging on the tripod. I just leave it next to me. And I would get one of these cloths to clean your filters. I use a Purestone one. It's really, really nice. I'm gonna include a link to all these filters that you can get on Amazon. It's an affiliate link, so if you do buy it through those links, I do get a little bit of money, but it just helps me get these videos out and do more. So I would appreciate it if you do, but if you don't, that's fine too. I don't really care. I just wanted to talk about the filters. The other thing I wanted to talk about is I actually did a t-shirt that I'm gonna wear in my videos from now on, just to have a bit of fun with it. And you can actually get one of these t-shirts. I'm gonna include the link for the t-shirt as well. It's just a bit of fun with it, since I already always say "you know" way too many times. So it's just my logo with the letter, with the words "you know" under it. So if you guys want, you can also order one. I have, I think, 9 available for sale through Teespring. And you can actually order them. I think Teespring, that's their name. It's just an online company. And I also have the shirt available in stores. So there's, if you, more than 10 people, I hope they buy it. It's, you know, there's more available, so don't worry about that. But if you guys get that too, you'd be helping me out a little bit, even more, by getting a tiny little bit of profit, just so I can pay some expenses. But that's kind of it for today's video. And I'm just kind of cleaning up my filters today before I go out shooting tomorrow. So I thought maybe might as well do a video about it and tell you about the filters I use. If you have any questions about these filters, let me know in the description, at the bottom of the video, and I'll be happy to answer it. See you guys. Bye.